Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. I'm Christina. I'm glad you're here. Welcome to a profound change, the MLM world. Monate has the new Visionary Founders Pool and one of their top market partner at the executive director rank is going to explain to us what that means. If you would like to know the facts, then I will link the original video up here where I showed you the facts, what that actually is, what their Visionary Founders Pool is, what their other founders pools are. And this is kind of the Monate edition where the market partners explain that themselves. There is a lot of very entertaining content, very false content also available on social media from current Monate distributors. So there are also going to be maybe an occasional video here or there where I will react to this as well. But this is Monate's best, biggest, newest thing that allegedly will change lives of people. Ever since June 3rd, Monate announced that they're launching the Visionary Founders Pool, where the Monate Hunts are able to receive 1% share in the North America area, that is North America and Canada, 1% of the commissionable revenue in a quarter. And this baby is called the Visionary Founders Pool. So let's get started.
Good morning, Team No Sleep over here. We're all still very excited about the announcement from just a couple days ago, but I'm gonna do an explained situation and go over what is Visionary Founders Pool, what is it not, what does this mean? What does this mean? It always reminds me of Friends. What does this mean? And then how can you start and get on your way to earning them, okay? Because this isn't like you just join now and boom, you're getting them. Like there's some work involved. Obviously, it's a job. So anyways, what is it? The Visionary Founder Pool.
What is the Visionary Founders Pool? That's the actual name. It's a stupid name.
It is brand new, okay? It just launched a couple days ago. And what it means is that the company is taking their North American current profits, okay? From their current revenue. Because oftentimes, like when we launch in a new country, we will say, okay, there's an opportunity when it's brand new that you can earn a profit share in that market, you know, for up to the first year. And so there's always like, that's the incentive in companies like this to be like a part of the growth, because you can usually get like a piece of the pie if you are kind of in the right place at the right time. Okay. So whenever we do that, that happens. So for a lot of us that joined, you know, I joined when the company was almost 3 years old. And so I didn't have that opportunity. I completely missed it. I didn't even know what money was when they launched here and had their big, you know, original founder share pool. So a couple years ago, they launched an emerging founder pool. Some of you may remember if you've been around for a while. I was really excited about that. I am a 3-share emerging founder holder. And what that is a profit share past a certain level of revenue, okay? So that's great, that's there, and it's amazing, and that's from the North American region. This, I thought, was gonna be something similar to that, but what this is even better than that. So what they're doing is allowing us, 10 years later, to get a piece of what the original founder pool is. So it's on current and future revenue that the company brings in. Okay. So, and it's from the North American market. The North American market is 83% of Monate's current revenue. Okay. So when you think about, you know, the success of Monate, and I know probably many of you have thought, oh, it's really saturated here. Like I need to find someone in a different country. And it's like, no, it's actually not. Like it's a small amount of people that are actually market partners. Like I still talk to people every single day who have never heard of Monate.
If the North American revenue is 83% of Monate's current revenue from the US and Canada, it means that the company is not doing well and they never took off in Europe and in Australia and in New Zealand. I have said it before, but I'll mention it here again. There are only, at this point, older income disclosure statements available from the US and Canada from 2022, none for Europe, none for Australia, and none for New Zealand. And I always suspected that the income disclosure statements from the US and from Canada are the best. They're best looking. They're even worse in other territories. And the US one and the Canadian one, they're not great. Most people will lose money. That is true to this entire industry, but they're still very likely the best one out of all of the markets. And that's why we don't see income disclosure statements in any of the other markets that are already available and where you can operate already for years. There is to this day no updated income disclosure statement for Monate for 2023, so we still have to work with the old numbers. She mentioned it and said, well, a lot of people don't even know what Monate is. Monate is saturated. The US is saturated. They burned through so many people that joined Monate at some point, specifically during the pandemic, and they're not joining them ever again. They very likely stepped away from MLMs in general, because MLMs in general are currently not doing well. In addition to that, there are lawsuits from Monate's top distributor, their first distributor actually, and also from their former president. And a lot of Huns actually speak out now factually about Monate numbers, about the diminishing revenue, about their income tanking, them making less and less money, although they were somewhere in the middle of the compensation plan and they hardly made any money. I have an entire playlist about Monate where that is a huge topic at the moment, and a lot of the people are actually speaking up about this. That is why the US market is very much saturated. And she's already misrepresenting this to a certain degree, because you're not getting shares in the revenue or in the profit of the company. You have the ability to get 1% of the commissionable revenue the company generates in one quarter. Commissionable revenue isn't necessarily all of the products that Monate sells. There are certain products that are not considered commissionable. A lot of their flash sales, if they have huge bundles, about 20 to 30% of the money Monate makes very likely is not commissionable income. So you're not participating in everything that the company sells in North America and in Canada. It is only a certain portion out of the revenue they make, and out of that, 1% will be shared among all of the Monate distributors who are eligible for this. In the original video I uploaded last time, I spoke about the requirements, what you have to do, what ranks you have to hit, who you have to help, up to what rank if you want to participate, and it doesn't look it is that simple. For the current market partner, it looks easier than for new market partners joining, and that is very likely the goal at the moment, to keep the people who are in the company within the company, because so many people are leaving, but it is still hardly doable. For a lot of them, it means that they need to hit the MM rank, that is the Cadillac rank, or one rank or two ranks above their current rank. It sounds very much doable for them to do that within a year if they want to have one share, or within a month if they want to have two shares. But Monate is not just generously spreading money. They are very well aware how hard it is to rank up, to have enough people on your team to achieve the downline volume and the group volume, the amount of product people need to sell within 1 month, that it is very unlikely that a lot of people will even be able to hit these ranks. Very likely it will be, yet again, the top people who are able to participate in this. And then you also need to keep your rank. If you drop in rank, yet again, you're not able to participate in this, then you're kicked out of this pool for good. So there's a lot of hype, there's a lot of excitement for pretty much nothing.
So there's still huge, huge opportunity for growth, and we have a 5-year plan to grow to be a multi-billion dollar brand. And basically, it's like so unreal that we will be able to earn the profit share pool from this and then get a piece of the pie of what Monate's revenue is quarterly. So it's not like you'll join in, you can join and you can make a, you know, percentage of, you know, your sales and what your team does, but this is a percentage of what North America does as a whole. So even like all my sidelines that live around me and people on other teams, if they're in Monate and they're in North America and they're selling in North America, you're going to see so much camaraderie between sidelines and this uplifting community, because it's like everyone's going to be a shareholder in the company. Okay. So that's like in a layman's terms, how I can explain what it is. So it's a profit share pool based on current and future. So as the company grows, those shares will grow, and the shareholders, that are emerging founder shareholders, those are past, it's a percentage past 300 million. So that's like, this is like everything between that. Okay, so now if you are an emerging founder, you can double end it basically. So you're gonna get past that and you're gonna get everything to that. And the pool size is gonna vary. So we can't necessarily give like a profit share, guesstimate, but originally they were saying they were up to five figures when Money8 was in their peak 2020 sales, like most businesses. 2020, 2021, we saw, and we hear people talk about like those, peak numbers that people had and people were selling and things like that. So even my husband's business, he's in the home improvement industry, and the window business boomed in 2020, 2021. And, now we're seeing like the remnants of what being in a recession is doing and what's happening in the world and inflation and all that kind of stuff. So the fact that Money8 is up month over month is huge. Like this company, I can't even believe they're doing this. They don't have to. They could literally just pocket this revenue, but they're choosing to say, you know what? No, anybody that's here that's building, we want you to have this opportunity for our 10-year anniversary. So really, really, their generosity is just insane.
This has nothing to do with generosity. At this point, I do believe that Money8 has to do these things if they want to celebrate their 10-year anniversary in an arena where a bunch of people actually show up. I think that this is, at this point, really essential for the survival of the company to offer something like this. She has already misspoken many, many times. That is why I'm going to show you and I'm going to read to you what Money8 says this visionary founders pool is and what you can achieve. And there will be a lot more misrepresentation. That is why I think it is important to state that very, very clearly. The visionary founders pool offers the opportunity to receive quarterly payouts based on 1% of Money8 North America's commissionable revenue for the quarter on top of your regular earnings. And she's right, she cannot give any figures or any numbers, but Money8 is losing market partners. At their peak time, the top people who were able to participate in the original founders pool, who joined early, who were able to hit the MM rank within a year, people like Julie Stevens, Ann Fisher, Tony Van Choik very likely was also one of those. They were very likely able to make a couple of $10,000 per quarter during the peak time of Money8. That is not the case anymore. This will very likely be a couple of $100 if. And also the pool that she mentions, that is the emerging founders pool, is based on the assumption that the company sells more than $75 million per quarter in North America. And then this founders pool will give 1%, yet again, of the commissionable revenue to the people who were able to participate in it. 1% for everybody who is eligible for this. So it is not a great super duper opportunity. It is hard to achieve and the outcome will not be five figures. It won't. That was something that the original founders pool offered to some of those people, and that opportunity is dead. Also in the other territories, in Europe and in the Asia Pacific, people very likely make $100, $200, $300 per quarter when they participate in this founders pool. And now with revenue being down, they're making even less. The same will very likely be true here as well. If Money8 wants to celebrate its 10-year anniversary in autumn, they need to do stuff like this. It doesn't mean that the company is generous. They're fighting for their survival to keep the people, the market partners who are in the company interested so that they can work for another year trying to hit this bogus founders pool that will very likely only give them a couple of $100 if they're able to hit those ranks and if they're able to keep those ranks. And they're able to work for an entire year trying to recruit as many people as possible and trying to sell as much product as possible so that not more and more market partners are leaving, and giving them a tool so that it makes it easier for them to try and recruit new market partners. But it is not that easy. who was able to participate in these founders pools, the top people. And the same very likely is true here as well. That is why she, as a 3-share emerging founder, is on her Instagram and is telling us that this is the greatest opportunity ever. It's presenting this to some poor sucker to convince them to join Monate, a drowning MLM, so that she can continue to make some money and so that she can continue to pay for her lifestyle. And so that she can hopefully rank up to the SED rank again. You're also not a shareholder in the company because Monate is a private company and not a publicly traded company. You will get no shares. The founders pool, the emerging founders pool, and now also the visionary founders pool, they are, if you're able to participate in these, just words that define a bonus payment that you might or might not receive. It is a potential bonus payment that you can earn if you fulfill the requirements, if you hit the ranks, if you sell the product, and if you keep that rank. And in addition to that, you also cannot leave Monate, because if you leave Monate, you're not able to participate in these pools as well. And let's see about the camaraderie in Monate. They will just try to recruit as many people as possible to hit ranks or to keep ranks, to promote or to promote a new recruit to a rank they need to recruit that new recruit to, so that they're able to participate in this. And she is currently at the ED rank, the executive director rank, that is the second from the top. That is not too shabby, but at some point she was also an SED, and she needs to hit the highest rank again by June 30th, 2025 to receive 1 share in this pool, and to earn 2 shares, she has to hit the highest rank again by September 30th, 2024. With all of the people still leaving Monate and being very outspoken how bad Monate is, that is a very, very difficult task. Monate's founders pool also depends on current and future commissionable revenue in North America for the quarter. How are those quarterly payouts going to be affected when more and more people are leaving the company? We have seen that throughout the income disclosure statements that more and more market partners have left. The market partners are the best customers. People are currently saving money. There are multiple crises in the world, and people have to be really, really mindful about how they spend their money. How likely is it that Monate's revenue is going to go up? Very likely won't. It will go down. It already did go down, and the company kind of artificially was pushed again during the pandemic, when people really thought that Monate could provide them a second stream of income or could provide for them and their families. But that is over. That time is gone, and Monate is on the decline, and so will be their revenue, and so will be these bonus payments, because the payouts will only go down, down, down. Even if some people are able to participate in this, the payout won't be much.
Okay, so now, what is it not? Okay, because I see some people talking about this. They're like, oh, it's not real shares. Like, you can't trade them with the Dow Jones and NASDAQ. And like, it's not real shares. And I'm like, okay, well, let me tell you why it's better. Okay, because my husband he's a big stocks guy. Okay, like our holdings and our shares and everything, I'm hearing about it every single day. And look how much this stock's doing, look how much this stock's doing, all that kind of stuff. And so he'll be like, look at what our stocks did yesterday. And he's been investing since the pandemic hit, right? So it's like when everything's starting to go down and people are selling their shares and like, ooh, get out, get out, get out. He's like, that's when you double down. And like, that's like, I feel like Monate's allowing us this opportunity to like double down on what's happening right now. So basically, you want to be doubling down or buying in with shares in the stock market. But I will ask him all the time, I'll be like, well, okay, so it made that much money. Like, when does that go into our account? That's cool, but when is it? And he's like, no, you don't do stocks for a short game. Like you, and he's a long game stocks, which is why I think he's done so well, is because, you know, there's been days where they're down, down, down. And I'm sure if you or your significant other do the stock market, you can see their mood fluctuate based on how the market's doing, right? So he'll be like, you know, well, we leave it in because these shares are only going to grow. And so it's all about the long game. And the moment you pull it out, you don't have those shares anymore. So it's like, yes, there's an advantage to having shares in the stocks. However, for us, it's like, well, I'd like to see some of that, you know? And I think I'm a little spoiled by the idea of how Monate has always done their founder shares. So what it is it's not a stock, okay? It's actually more like a bonus.
Thank you. She could have said that from the get-go. Monate shares are not holding shares like in a publicly traded company. It's a bonus payment, and that's truly all this is.
So you will receive this quarterly on your commission check. So what is really cool about it is you will have these shares. So let's say I'm going for 2 shares. I don't know about you, drop in the chat, going 1, going 2, but I'm going for 2 shares. So once I lock in and become a 2-share visionary founder, I will always have those 2 shares as long as I maintain the criterion to do so, which at this point in my business happens basically on the 1st or 2nd of the month. So
I doubt that. She is at the ED rank. She needs to rank up by September 30th if she wants to be a 2-share visionary founder participant. Wow. I mean, these words, they're really frying my brain. If that was that easy, she wouldn't even have lost the rank of SED. So it's not that easy.
You can grow your business to be that sustainable. And that's really what we try to help our team members do. And that's what most people's goal is. Okay, so yes, go for 2. I love it. All in the chat. Here live with me. Okay.
Also, it's BS because she is an exception to the rule that she is even able to hit some of the higher ranks. Most people will very likely not be able to participate in the founders pool. And if you drop in a rank, MM very likely for most, that is the Cadillac rank, that is the middle rank that most people have to hit, that new market partners also have to hit. If you fall below that, or if you leave Monate, you will not participate in these bonus payments anymore. Never again. It's not shares in the stock. Like she said, exactly, it is not. That is why these are not comparable. It is just a potential bonus, and in my opinion, a tool to keep people in the company and to motivate people to recruit and to sell products. And since MLMs themselves are not sustainable, you also cannot set up a sustainable MLM business to consistently participate in these bonus payments. That's bogus.
So if you're going for 2 shares, I will lock in those shares. So, but it's, my husband was like, oh, it's more, he's like, people that don't know stocks might not know these terms, but it's more like a dividend. He's like, Apple's doing something like this right now. I think he said it was Apple, where they're making so much that they're trying to get some cash out. So basically I'm a 2-share founder profit share holder. So every quarter I will get my 2 shares paid out to me from whatever North America did based on the pool size, based on the profit size. And then I will get that payout on my check. And then, but I'm still a 2-share holder. So in the traditional sense, once you get paid out on your stocks, they're gone. But in this sense, you continue to have those shares. So it's just like it's a better way to have shares, in my opinion.
You're not having shares. It's just the potential to participate in a bonus payment. And if she's talking about the emerging founders pool before, I didn't catch that. She's also only able to participate if Monate makes more than $75 million per quarter in North America and in Canada. So it looks like she won't be getting a lot of payout from that because Monate is far from 75 million per quarter.
And so it is like the better the company does, the better your shares are doing. The same with other stocks. You know, I was like, Josh was like, do not talk about this. Like, you do not know enough to talk about the stock market. But I was like, well, explain to me why, you know, like how a publicly traded company works versus like we're a private company. So it's very different. And so he's like, well, he's like, we own shares in Honest Company, for example. He's like, credible company, they're doing great. You know, their shares have gone up, they go down, they're not doing well right now. And so people start selling the shares, which makes your value go down. So it's not even just on the revenue, it's based on the people that are actually buying the stocks, okay? So I know. My husband, he's probably gonna, if he's gonna watch this, he's gonna cringe and be like, and I'm like, we should just get you on to talk about this then, okay? So anyways, this is my way of forcing him to do that, by the way. So anyway, it's just cool because while we're working for this company, we can do our best to support the entire region that's gonna be, you know, for the profit shares, which We have girls on our team who are profit shareholders in Europe, Australia, North America, and you know, the Asia Pacific pool, which is actually the largest in the world. And so they're only going to be expanding that too. So there's going to be opportunities for you while you're working on this. You will also be locking in your eligibility for these other ones once you start, you know, getting your feet wet and learning this business. And it really is a simple business. Okay, so that's what it is, what it isn't, okay?
She's really great at explaining this knot because it also matters to her how many people are able to participate. This example, this analogy to owning actual stocks, actual shares in a company is not valid here. So let's forget this. If you ever hear this, this is not valid. It is not like having a share in a stock market with Apple or what was it, the Honest Company or the Floofy Company, whatever it is you want to invest in. It's not comparable to Monate, but you're able to participate in this baby and you might be able to participate in 1% of the commissionable revenue in that area. If 1,000 people participate in this, then you will get a certain amount of money. If 10,000 people, for starters, participate in this, you will also get a certain percentage, but then you will get less than you would receive if it was 1,000 people. If it's just one person that is eligible for this 1%, then they get the entire thing. But that is something she also has to take into consideration. The more people are able to participate in this, the smaller the share for each and every person, so the smaller the bonus payment for each and every person participating in this will be. And in my opinion, with Monate losing market partners as we speak, this bonus will very likely be only a small bonus to start with, and it will only go down and down and down. And I would also like to understand what this bonus is actually based on the alleged fraudulent low revenue insinuated by Stuart McMillan in his lawsuit against Monate, that Monate keeps their revenue artificially low. Rather, the Urdaneta family, the owners of Monate, do so also to avoid paying out the founder's share they owe the market partners, or the bad revenue, the horrible revenue that, according to the Urdaneta family and their counterclaim against Stuart McMillan's lawsuit, who say that he is solely responsible for Monate not doing well. So we are already involved in bad revenue all over, and that is what we're going to participate in. I mean, the Huns should be reading the lawsuits. That is really, really impressive. And I think it would be very beneficial for them because both parties say pretty much Monate is not doing well. Different reasons. They all have their very own driver why they're doing that. But both parties are essentially saying the same thing, that revenue is down. And so do the market partners. So does Tony Venchoik, or rather her husband, who is currently very outspoken on social media. And so are also former Monate market partners who are now leaving to other MLMs. Their incentive, of course, is to make it sound like Monate is doing really, really bad, but other MLMs are so much better, to try and get their former teammates to their new grift, to their new MLM. But the stories are very, very similar. And where there's smoke, there is fire. Revenue is down. Even if you're able to participate in this, you will hardly get a couple of $100 out of this per quarter. I'm sure of this.
So what does this mean? This means that right now is a very large opportunity to be in the right place at the right time. This company we know works. We know it's sustainable through a pandemic. We grew 700 or 600 and I don't remember what the actual number, it was like 618 or something percent as a team during 2020, 2021. That was like our personal team. The company grew like crazy. And just like every business, it goes up, it goes down, it goes up, it goes down.
You cannot compare a multi-level marketing company and how a multi-level marketing company was selling or performing during the pandemic with a recruitment-based business like Monate. Because MLMs were thriving, most of them were, during the pandemic, but now they see the after effect. Now revenue is down, people have more opportunities and are leaving Monate and the MLM business. Monate was thriving during the pandemic, and now they're not. And that's why we have incentives like this now.
That is business. However, what we know about our plan, what we've brought in, what our current and plans are, and so we don't know what corporate and our CEO has up their sleeve and where they're going to expand and what markets they're going to go in and They've leaked a couple things that I probably can't say on here that are very exciting that I know will only make it more simple for people to become customers and, you know, all that kind of stuff. So without saying too much, basically, we know what works and we know what's working and we know that there's a big plan for the future. So for me, investment wise, looking in, my husband's like, this is when you double down on a business. And really very truly exciting. So it means that, you know, we've all stepped into a time capsule and you have an opportunity to be a part of something from the ground, like essentially the ground floor, even though it's already credible, it's already built and established, and we already have proven significant systems in place. And it's only getting better, only more countries, only more products, only more launches. It's like just really exciting. It truly, truly is exciting. That's why a lot of us aren't sleeping, is because we know, because we've already experienced the significance of what's possible and what is. And it's changed a lot of our lives. And it doesn't have to be millions and millions and millions of dollars to do that. But just imagine doing some work and, you know, getting your own team commissions and then also getting a commission based on what the company does as a whole. Like, that's just, it's mind blowing. Okay.
I refuse to believe that she has any actual insights in the company whatsoever, because the past month have shown us that the Monate Market Partners, they know very, very little about the state of the company, and Monate Corporate also does not fill them in. She does not get sleep because hundreds of thousands of market partners have left Monate over the past 2 years alone, and she is feeling that. Her paycheck is feeling this, and she needs to continue to recruit and to use the tools that Monate gives their market partners to recruit more and to sell more. And this is one of those tools, so that this non-sustainable tanking MLM is not drowning as fast as they currently do. More and more people are leaving to the olive tree people. The first market partner was kicked out of the company and is now also in a new MLM. Kendall Weldon, also one of the top 10 people, one of Monate's top elite partners, is going to a new Truly. Sketchy company. There's also a video coming up. I mean, she kind of hit the nail on the head, but those types of people are leaving because they don't see a future for them in Monate because their money is down. And likely that is also the reason why she lost the top rank and is now at the ED level. She is not an SED, according to Eric Worre and according to a statement from him. Maybe she has ranked up again, maybe she has fallen in rank, but she was at the top of the company for years, and it seems like she is not anymore. That is why she needs to recruit more people and to sell more product.
So how can you start to earn them? Well, if you are currently a market partner, get plugged in, okay? Monate has multiple outlets, okay? Monate Official on Instagram, Monate Official on Facebook, and you can get plugged in. There's calls happening galore, okay? All of the leaders are very, very united and sharing their trainings. We're doing lots of calls, so just get plugged in wherever you can, because we got a lot going on that's open company-wide, okay? So there's that. So you can have the opportunity to get trained from multitude of leaders in the company that are very successful. And spoiler alert, we all do the same things. We just do them a little differently. So you'll be able to kind of pick up what other people are doing that are working. If you are not a market partner yet, I would love to chat with you about this opportunity. Or maybe someone sent you this video. Chat with them about this opportunity. But right now, you just buy your product pack, okay? And it's funny, my husband and I were talking about scam, people that call this a scam last night, and I just wish he would come on here, because his outlook and the way he says everything is so, it's just hilarious. And it's like, yeah, that is so true. And he's like, okay, scam, huh? Okay, so you spend $149, you get over $300 worth of products, samples, marketing materials, and then what? And I'm like, well, then nothing. Like, you don't have to spend another dollar if you don't want. He's like, where's the scam then? It's not charging you every month. There's no sales quota. There's no, like, you know, and I'm like, I don't really know. Like, I think people think, because there's a lot of people out there that will market this and say, as almost like a get rich quick kind of a situation. And I feel like a lot of the leaders, we do our best to kind of explain, like, no, there's work involved. Like, we want you to know, you know, there's this way that you can do it, but you got to work for it. You know, I even had a couple people DM me and be like, oh, so I can join now and have an opportunity at that? Do I have to grow a team? And I'm like, well, yeah, you got to work your business to have an opportunity like this. But either way, if you were going to have the opportunity and seize the opportunity, you were going to eventually want to have some sort of goals, right? That was going to involve team building, which to me is the most rewarding part of this, is getting to help other people help other people. And so I wouldn't want to be, I've had the opportunity to be a part of a lot of affiliate programs. It feels very selfish. It feels very like, oh, I'm going to send you a link. You might like the product, but I'm going to get a commission. I can't teach you how to make a commission on it. Right. And like, so anyways,
it is not selfish if you do affiliate marketing. It is selfish when you are in an MLM and when you misrepresent the business opportunity. And that is also why it's a scam. And what would be a Monet video without a Monet Han or her husband addressing the haters? Or it's a scam. That is so laughable. Monet is a scam. And she, in my opinion, is a scammer because of the misrepresentation of the Monet business. She's not telling us what the Monet business model actually is. It is not a get-rich-quick scam. Also, the Huns, some 4 or 5 years ago, that is something that they pitched. Like, well, you can get a millionaire and you can do that really quickly and really easily. And a lot of anti-MLM content creators and the public also caught up with the misrepresentation of get-rich-quickly in MLMs and in Monet. And the Huns, they had to change their way of misrepresentation. It is still a misrepresentation, though. During the pandemic, the misrepresentation was false health and income claims to make additional money by pretending that people can make an additional income, when Monet's income disclosure statements show us across the board that that is not true. When they were recruited with the idea to make an additional income or to substitute the income from a job, they were scared to attend or they got laid off from. This right here, all of this we have seen so far, is a misrepresentation of the current Monet business opportunity. It is not about selling shampoo. It is not about loving the product. It is about recruiting. Same for the Visionary Founders Pool and what we've heard from her so far. You can only participate in this baby when you are not in the company yet, when you hit at least the MM rank. That is the Market Mentor rank, the car program, the Cadillac rank. And in 2022, only 0.21% of the people were able to hit that rank. 0.3% of the people were able to hit that rank and the higher ranks up to the SED rank. She has not mentioned any of those essential details to us yet. And spoiler alert, she won't in this entire pitch. And that is why Monet's business opportunity and the way she presents it is a scam. It is highly, highly irresponsible to recruit new people in 2024 into Monet. This is not about other people, helping others, building your business. That means recruitment. She is building her business, so she's recruiting people for her own good, not for other people's paychecks. And this is Monet's compensation plan. What you see here is quotas and requirements that distributors have to fulfill every single month to receive any payment at all. That is why the way she presents the business opportunity is a lie and is a scam, when you clearly have regular quotas and sales and recruitment requirements. How many people who joined Monet were able to turn a starter pack investment into a livable income without fulfilling any of those requirements, without spending any additional money? And how many were even able to make a profit at all? That is why Monet has been described by many, including myself, as a scam.
I think there was a question in here. Let me look. Oh, what are the products? Okay. The products are
the insignificant products. We're mentioning them now, over 15 minutes into this live. But it's about the products, right? You're a shampoo dealer. Sure, you are. Of course. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Vegan, cruelty-free, anti-aging, hair care, and basically beauty products. There are skincare, hair care, and wellness items. The hair care, game-changing, color safe, extension safe, They help your hair look healthier, fuller looking, shinier looking, go longer between washes. If you have an imbalanced scalp or you're unhappy with your hair manageability wise, I don't know anybody that doesn't want fuller looking, healthier looking hair. But if you already have that, then you will have, you know, maybe want to use cleaner products. Maybe you're getting more ingredient conscious. So things like that. So I'm very, very, very excited about it. So you buy your box, you get over $300 worth of products, and then, okay, you get the opportunity to be trained and start working your business. Almost like I would say within the hour, your website will be active to where you can start earning commissions. And that's always my first goal with a partner is like, let's help you make your money back right away. The company is doing something really cool for the month of June. If you enroll with a product pack, you will also get $100 to shop with next month, or like use, you know, towards orders next month. And then let's say I enroll you, I will also get $100 coupon. So you bring people on, you will be able to accrue extra coupons on top of your commissions towards everything. So anyways, it's really cool. Like, especially if there's a lot of products that you want to try, it really is amazing. Okay. So, how can you start to earn them? So what you're going to want to do right now.
Oh, thank God there's a dog. When the door opened, I thought it was the ghost of Monate, past distributors who have left, but it's a dog. I didn't pay full attention at this point, and I thought, why is the door suddenly open? Ghosts? No, dogs.
If you're like, okay, I want to go, start building blocks, okay? And your first goal is going to be there is the core rank, which is MMP. It's the first rank. And then there's the fourth rank called MMB that we call our cornerstone rank. This is a $500 bonus. This month in June, if you hit that rank, you will earn yourself an iPad. Okay? An iPad for hitting the rank. People the last 2 years have hit that rank and got their $500 bonus and been stoked. But this month you do it, you're gonna also get an iPad and your $500 bonus. And all of these bonuses, by the way, that I speak of are paid out the next month on the commission check. It's not a payment plan. It's not broken down into multiple. If you do this, you get that, which I love. And that also makes it less scammy, right? I feel like a scam's like, oh, well, you know what? You gotta do it a couple times in a row before we're gonna give you that. And the founder shares, There is a criterion for that pool, and it does involve eventually hitting the Motor Club rank or the Cadillac rank, which I've had girls join me. I had someone last year join me and hit it in the first month. I've had people hit it in the second month. We've had people on our team hit it in their third month, fourth month, fifth month, and then many hit it within a year, and then many hit it within their 2 year mark. So no matter where you're at right now, just know it's possible, but you have to believe. Okay. And I've done a lot of talk about statistics. I talked about it in my founder highlight. I talked about it on a live the other day. And just like, if you're someone that's focused on statistics, even Josh and I talked about it in our live yesterday, and it was like, you know, how many kids play soccer their whole life, and then statistically how many end up, you know, going pro? And so it's like, would you tell your kid, don't do it, you're not going to go pro? Like, you know, no, you want to pour belief into people that want something, because it takes belief to get there, and it takes a support of belief to get there as well.
My head really hurts. And that is yet again another example why Monate and her presentation and her comparison to people playing football and not being able to work as a pro are a scam. If you are new, let's get back to the actual business opportunity first. If you are new to Monate and you want to participate in this new founders share pool, you need to start building blocks. You need to hit the MM, the car rank. And how do you do that? By recruiting a shit ton of people so that you can hit your requirements and your quotas, your structural and your sales volume quotas. And we have not heard her say recruit once. She claims that 3 to 4 people in her downline were able to hit that MM rank within 3 months to a year. Some people were able to hit it after a year. A lot of people were able to hit it after a couple of years. How many people do you have on your team who are actively running their business that were never able to hit that rank ever despite their best efforts? How many? If we're talking about statistics, we would like to know how many people are on your team in general, where on your team, and how many people overall were ever able, considering that number, were ever able to hit the MM rank. But we're not getting that information from her. And that is why this is a scam. She has not spoken about the likelihood of people being able to hit those requirements. And she also said, you don't have any quotas or anything you need to do. If you want to make money, you have to. You have to hit ranks and you have to sell products and you have to recruit people. If you don't want to make money, why do you join Monet then? Doesn't make any sense. That's why this is a scam.
Which is one of the reasons I did that live with Josh, because we need to pour belief on so many people who have done from the word and the mouth of people that have done it, because I've done it. I believed. I had people that believed in me, and I can believe in you. And that's what you're going to need to be successful in this. It's the same with athletes and things like that. And for this, you don't even have to go pro. You just gotta really fall in love with playing the game.
No, it's not. You need to recruit the most people to hit all of the requirements that she's not talking about. And you cannot compare a child doing physical activity like playing football and say, well, how many of those kids go pro? The incentive, the idea for kids is to move their body and to play something, to learn about being a member of an actual team, about doing sports together. And that's why they never intend to go pro, because it requires not only belief, but also a certain amount of talent. You need to have some sort of qualification to actually be a pro. But most kids don't start to do sports because they want to be a pro. Most people start Monate because they get this pitched as a business opportunity where they can make a side hustle or a substantial income or become rich and famous. Scam.
And I think that's the statistic people should be focusing on is, you know, how many people end up really, truly enjoying this. And we have people, and I've received, I don't even know how many messages from people that are like, I've always loved doing this. I've done it on the side. I think I'm ready to pick it up a notch. And I'm like, great. And they're realtors, nurses, teachers, like all different walks of life.
Why are these the statistic that she wants us to focus on? Because all of the statistics concerning Monate and MLM are not in her favor. Because most people, business-wise, make no profit. They lose money. So yeah, let's start with statistics. How many people in MLMs wear pink shirts or enjoy the journey? Something that is not really factually measurable. I mean, you could measure how many people are wearing pink shirts daily who are in Monate. But those numbers are not in her favor. The numbers that are out there, that are facts, that are non-discussable, that are non-disputable, they're not in her favor. That's why she doesn't want to acknowledge them.
And I love the melting potness of this and what we do, because right now they are not just offering. Actually, I would say it's even probably more difficult for the SEDs or the top rank in the company to qualify for this. So a lot of people will say, oh, they only take care of people at the top and the blah, 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 and the top. And it's like, actually, this is a great opportunity for everyone in the beginning, in the middle. Like, it really is. And you now also have the opportunity to sell this as part of your, you know, what you get to offer people, which is a huge advantage, because a lot of people out there are looking for a ground floor. They are looking to, start with something and have the opportunity to grow with something. And it's like, this is it. And we already are tried and true. We're not a startup that can be very risky. So, and a lot of startups don't make it, or a lot of startups will say, oh, we're going to promise you shares. And then they end up going public, which is suicide for a network marketing company. That does not go well. The two don't go hand in hand together. Being a network marketing company or being a publicly traded company. Because often what can happen is that company can go bankrupt and then boom, ba-doop, ba-doop, there go your shares. But thanks, you just built this company to what it was and now it's gone. Bye-bye and thank you for your work. But it went bankrupt, it sold to someone else, and now there's nothing you can do about it. So I love that our CEO is very transparent about never wanting to leave the network marketing channel. I think for someone looking for somewhere to put their eggs in a basket, as far as network marketing is concerned, you do want to choose a company for sure that's not ever planning to go public. That's like 100%. So anyway, great opportunity. If you're just kind of tuning in, I don't know what just happened. I feel like I went in another algorithm and just the influx of people came on. But go back and watch the live. This was kind of everything you need to know, like the crash course on visionary founders and what it means and what it isn't. And, you know, it's part of a perk. It's a new perk, and it's potentially a life-changing one for a lot of people that are going to earn it. And I personally am very excited about earning it myself and helping as many people that partner with me do the same.
Yeah, I'm going to stop her right here and right there because it's enough. This is not going to be a life-changing opportunity. I assume it will be maybe $100, $200, or $300 for most people if they're able to participate in this. And she is just really eating her foot. Is this how you say it? I mean, she's not eating her own hair with a marinade product there, which is good. But is this shade towards the olive tree people, where Olivida, the company that runs the olive tree people, the MLM model in the United States and soon also in Canada, where Olivida is a publicly traded company, someone is really, really desperate. Don't ever join an MLM if they go public and they actually offer you stocks. Because our CEO is really transparent, but your CEO also said, we're never going to go retail with Monet. They have an Amazon store where you can buy a certain array of Monet products. So yeah, the Urdaneta family and your top boss is really, they're really reliable. Monet, in my opinion, is a multi-level marketing company that is currently committing suicide. So it is funny that she is shitting on other MLMs because Monet is deleting people's accounts left and right. They're canceling market partners' accounts and they're not able to get the numbers up. That's also why we have this weird visionary founders pool incentive that she really sucks at presenting. Monet is a bad opportunity. Most people will not be able to participate in this pool. The revenue from Monet is down, so 1% is not a lot of the commissionable revenue in a quarter in North America, the United States, and in Canada. Paychecks are going down, down, down. The people who are able to potentially participate in this will very likely hustle over the course of a year so that they're able to receive $100, $200, or $300 per quarter. And if you're not able to fulfill your requirements anymore, if you drop in rank, then you're screwed. And if you leave the company, you don't get anything either. So it's a win-win for all of us, right? I mean, English is not my first language, so I might misspeak and it's actually a loss-loss. But in all honesty, Monet is a bad opportunity. And this shows the desperation of the company, in my opinion, and also of the market partners who either don't understand what this pool actually is, or they purposefully misrepresent this opportunity. So let's not join Monet and let's not try to join the visionary founders pool. More videos are coming your way also from Monet because some of the top people, they have left Monet and they're joining new MLM sketchy adventures. And one of them is exceptionally weird and exceptionally funny. So I'm going to react to that as well. Stay tuned for these types of videos if you enjoy them. I would like to say thank you also to all of the returning people who come back to these videos every week, watch a lot of the videos, comment, share, like. Really, really appreciate that you're here, that you're supporting this channel. And also hello to all of the new people who have newly subscribed. The channel has hit 1,500 subscribers not too long ago, which is really exciting and unexpected. And it's really wonderful to see the slow but steady growth of this channel and of this community. And I do hope that you like these videos. It's a lot of Monet videos at this point again, but there's so much happening that I also think it is important to stay on top of the game. And I also genuinely like to snark on Monet. There are also other videos coming your way, so no worries. And if you like these types of videos, then please subscribe, like, comment, share, you know, all of these things that really helps the channel out a lot. And if you like these types of videos, then hopefully I will see you in my next one. Until then, cheers!